Planet Dolan.
From only using the bathroom at certain times to having to always wear snow pants, the Planet Dolan crew reenacts some of the best true stories from our subreddit about the weirdest rules our schools have ever had. I'm Melissa, and today I'll be your narrator. Number 10 was submitted by Red Guacamole 125. At Soup School, it's against the rules to use the bathroom between 12 o'clock and 12:30. The reason for the ridiculous rule is because the janitors need a break. It doesn't matter how bad someone has to go to the bathroom. If someone is caught in the bathroom within that half hour, the offender will automatically get written up. Number 9 was submitted by Syrup Hat. Charkey School forbids water bottle flipping. While that might not be unusual, her school considers many things to be water bottle flipping. For example, if Charkey was to drop her bottle of water, it would be considered water bottle flipping. It wouldn't matter if it were dropped by accident. Even giving another student her water bottle would count. If the rule is broken, then whoever did it would be suspended. Number 8 was submitted by Life is Hard 101. It's against the rules at Gurgak School to wear shirts with words on them. The principal said that the reason for the rule was because the words on shirts could be offensive. Being the rebel he was, Gurgak never followed that rule back when he was a student there. Not only did he not follow the rule, but he was never caught. Looking back, Gurgak believes that probably wasn't a strictly enforced rule. Number 7 was submitted by NewRescuer. Back at Dolan's old high school, the administration banned computers. It was because that they thought the students were watching porn. What made it a stupid rule was that the school had a program that blocked those kinds of websites. Dolan was pissed about the rule, so he went to the principal one day and yelled,
"Look, we can't watch porn because there's a block."
The principal suspended Dolan for lying. Number 6 was submitted by Lame Game Guy 1. It was a rule at Martian School that, during lunch, everyone had to use a knife and fork for everything. Even if someone was eating a bag of potato chips, they still had to use a knife and fork. He found that out when he was about to eat a bag of chips. When they told him that he had to use a knife and fork instead of his hands, Martian got pissed and swore at them because he thought the rule was bullshit. He ended up getting banned from having school lunch for a week. Number 5 was submitted by CS Smiley 91. When he was a teacher, the middle school Hellbent taught at had a weird rule that all teachers had to follow. If a student got in trouble, corporal punishment had to be carried out. What made that rule even weirder was that the teachers had to ask the students if they wanted to be paddled. Of course, the students always refused to be paddled whenever a teacher asked. If a student refused corporal punishment, then their parents would get a phone call about their child's behavior. One time, Hellbent asked the principal, who also had to abide by the rule,
"So if a student can say no to a paddling, then what's the point of having the option of corporal punishment?"
The principal simply responded, "The school board passed it. That's all I know." Number 4 was submitted by LunarFox44. At Pecan School, nobody was allowed to wear headbands, jewelry, and t-shirts that didn't have the school's logo. When Pecan asked why the rule was in place, the principal said,
"Some students might get jealous. Either that, or other students might not appreciate what you like and bully you."
However, nobody at the school listened to the rule. Barely anyone was in the lunchroom because they were all serving detention for having violated the rule. Later on, if anyone was caught breaking the rule, then instead of a detention, they were suspended. Pecan once got a week off from wearing a Fallout Boy t-shirt. When her mom found out about the rule, she thought it was the dumbest thing she'd ever heard. Since a few other students she knew were also suspended, Pecan formed a plan with them. They texted and emailed everyone they knew about wearing inappropriate clothing to school, however long it took until the rule was gone. The people they texted or emailed told their friends to also wear clothing that went against the rule. Since the school couldn't suspend every student, they eventually got rid of the rule. Number 3 was submitted by CyberKenetic. Where Zaragamba comes from, everyone uses the word banter from time to time. However, the teachers at the secondary school he went to believed that saying the word was a form of bullying. The thing was, everyone in the class used the word banter to refer to something being funny. The school even gathered the entire school for an assembly about the use of the word and how it was prohibited. Zaragamba and his fellow students couldn't help but think, "Is this for real?" Number 2 was submitted by Pixel-Boi. There's a rule at Sid's school that he thinks is ridiculous. If a student has money to buy food, the teachers have to buy the food for them. The reason is because they want to make sure that the students aren't spending their money on something illegal. One time, a trashy-looking teacher that Sid had never seen before took his money and spent $30 on some greasy hash browns. The karma police caught up with her because she got food poisoning soon after. Number 1 was submitted by RapGod1017. Derek's old elementary school had a rule that, during winter, everyone had to wear snow pants for recess. Of course, it would depend on how long the snow took to completely melt. They would announce over the PA that they no longer had to wear snow pants on the day that winter technically ended, even if the snow melted several weeks before. So during the time that Derek was there, all the students were stuck wearing hard to move in snow pants when the schoolyard had no snow whatsoever. Huge thanks for the folks over on our Planet Dolan subreddit for submitting their stories. We have another question for you. What was the craziest thing that happened at a graduation? Let us know on the Reddit page linked below, and you might be featured in a future countdown. Catch you guys next time!